over to our next speaker. Sorry, Ruchi, we've been we're almost over the time that we had, but let me just give a quick introduction about Ruchi. She's going to talk about CX and DX from content developer lens. And Ruchi comes with 10 plus years of experience as a communications professional. She is a delivery manager at Innovatia in Bangalore. She has extensive experience in technical communication, CX, DX, strategy, delivery, recruitment, and training. She is passionate about research and user experience through UI, user-centric design, and information experience. Ruchi has been an active participant in the WTT meetups, and we're really thankful and appreciative for being such an active participant and sharing your knowledge with us. Ruchi, over to you.
Thanks, Raji. Thank you, everyone. And thanks for the wonderful presentation, Mirzula. It was really indeed very insightful, especially I think I also learned something from that. Thank you. So we are just wrapping up our last presentation, I'll keep it very short. I will be talking about connection with CX and DX from the content developer point of view. So when we talk about CX and DX, like how it is connecting to us as a content developer community, right? So just to give a background, what exactly does CX and DX mean here? So one sec. Yeah. So the status quo is like the 84% of the customers, they actually look forward for the experience, not for the products. Because we see what is the experience we are gaining out of when we buy any products, right? So it's more about experiencing, and in today's era, it is more about digital experience of that. We as a content developer, we connect with audience intuitively, right? So basically, we are the translators of this experience. We are customer conversation, you know, it hop on from social media to web page to your mobile without any hassle and in no time, very seamlessly. So the intent here of this presentation is to kind of make us aware, like, okay, this is like CX and DX and UX is a bigger thing. What exactly is in store for us in this particular platform? And what we can gain from it and how we can leverage that to make our content seamless across what we're talking about, the new digital experience platform. So going into that, let's understand what decode, what exactly UX, CX, and DX stands for. So as UX, we all know it is user experience. We have been talking about like from ages about it. So it all started with the interaction a user will have with an organization. When we all started with UX and UX design, it was only two mediums. Like when I remember I started in tech writing, we were like, okay, are you writing about a printer documentation or are you writing a web help, right? So it's all about the user experience online on a web page. That comes the UX part of it. Now, when we come into, when the world of this whole mobile application and everything came in place, we heard this term as CX, customer experience, where customer perceive all the interactions with your company over a period of time. And it is the basically the relationship experience which a customer is having with your brand. It can be on any platform. It can be your mobile. It can be your social platform. It can be your store visit. So it can be anything. And interchangeably, now people started using CX and UX. You know, sometimes user experience becomes the customer experience. Like you use a website and application to make a purchase and that becomes your user experience and also customer experience. When you purchase a product or service in order to use it, that becomes your customer experience. So it's very much, you know, there is a kind of blurred line between a customer experience and user experience. And customer experience is more broader than user experience. It's not only one interaction, but it's a chain of interaction which a user is having with your brand or your organization. So thanks to the pandemic thing, which happened in 2020, it brought another terminology in place, which is DX, which is digital experience. So we have seen that how we have shifted our focus from going in store and buying the stuff to entirely everything digital. So this is how the customer perceives the interaction strictly on the digital platform. That becomes a digital experience or digital user experience. Now, why we are talking about CX, UX, and DX, let's understand different kind of channels where we can use this. So we talk about the multi-channel where we are delivering content, considering the customer experience on more than one channel. But today, as we are sitting in 2021, we are talking about the omni-channel, right? We are understanding and optimizing the entire journey which the customer is facing. It can be, you know, okay, so I'm using my Instagram. I'm more of a home decor person. I'm liking something on Instagram on my page of home decor. I like that. And then when I go to Facebook, it populates because it's linked to my social account. It shows me some recommendations of home decor products, right? And then it shows me some kind of, you know, connections or groups where I can get connected and learn more about that particular, you know, how to decorate certain thing or how can do a DIY stuff, right? So how this is happening? There is a lot of interesting fact which is happening behind that is populating the content, right? And how this content is seamlessly across all the channels getting things what I want. It's a personalized and tailored content for me. So that becomes, that omni-channel becomes a channel which actually take up this content which we are talking about and where we are going to kind of, you know, give our input as we go along in the journey. This is just, you know, just to go over the different kind of, you know, interaction with the customer has. So we have a single interaction level where it's only a single point of, you know, contact with a single device. Then in the journey level, there is the entire journey which a person's actually walk through with that particular, keeping a goal in mind to do it. It can be buying a life insurance policy. So buying a policy, then renewing a policy, doing a payment, and then kind of claiming that policy, that entire becomes a journey, right? So they have different goals at different various point in between that whole journey of a customer buying a policy online to making a payment to, you know, renewing the policy and then claiming it. So there is a different spots in between where different channels which comes in between that journey, right? Then there is a relationship level. Now this journey actually is based on the relationship, like how the customer or a person is interacting with your company throughout this span when he has actually has one fixed goal with your brand, right? So how the relationship is happening. So that's about relationship level. It's very interesting to understand this, and it's very important also, because if we don't understand this customer journey and relationship level, we won't be able to come to a conclusion and define the content. You know, for that we need a context, right? We need a context, what are the pain points, and develop the content to kind of eliminate those pain points. So here is, we're talking about experience map and journey map. We talked about the journey. Now, what is experience map, right? So journey, we all understand, you know, you are having a goal. You probably, you know, you want to buy a policy with maybe ICICI, and that becomes your goal, right? You want to buy something from a policy from ICICI. That's one thing. Now, what is the experience map? Experience map is maybe I'm having my bank account in ICICI Bank. I'm also having my, you know, a mutual fund account or what we call, I also purchase shares with ICICI. So basically I'm having a wealth management portfolio. I'm having my locker, I'm having my FDs, and I'm having my policy also. So combinedly, basically I have one goal of a claim of a policy. That is my journey map. But my experience with ICICI is much larger than that particular journey. So basically, experience is nothing but a parent, and journey becomes a child of an experience map, right? In a simple context, if I want to call it out. So it's very important for us as a writer to understand what exactly the experience map is and what journey map is of a particular product which we are writing or working on. Once we understand that, we will be able to derive to the conclusion what are the different content we need to feed into system and what kind of writing we need to do so that there is this whole whatever in front of us, the pain points, or we call it the need, we can come with the content strategy for this 2021 customers. So there are basically four pillars of a great customer experience and digital experience. That is, the one is the customer data. So you need to track and analyze the customer interaction to gain insight inside the segment of your audience. With that, we'll be able to create and manage and publish the content across different channels, right? So these channels are different, right? Right now we talk about, we are spreading content on Twitter, we are writing something, we are writing white papers, we're writing banners, marketing campaigns, then we're creating personalized magazines like for the beauty products. So there is one beauty product which I think when there was a Christmas time, I was liking that page, and that created a personalized page for me that were the products I might like to order during the Christmas time. So that was amazing how the content, what I liked and what I wrote about, it clubbed together to give me a personalized and tailor-made content only for me, what I would like to place an order for. So that's really great. That's the data we're talking about right now. There is a lot more data and how we can leverage the data as a content writer by doing that data analytics and by understanding the data and how we can, you know, harness the customer data to give that rich digital experience to our customer, right? And to do all this, we need an integration. So we have, you know, audience targeting APIs, which can be integrated in your system, in your CRM system, that can help you to fetch data. So like, you know, I think Salesforce has Einstein, which artificial intelligence tool, which is actually plugged with your customer success platform, which helps you to create all this stuff, which I'm just talking about here. So you can go and you can look into, you know, the demo, how it works. So then it will give you a big idea, like what is the larger picture, what we're trying to achieve by, you know, doing all these things. So the key takeaways, I just want to kind of wrap it up here with this, is like, you need to understand your customer journey, who your customer is and what the journey the customer is actually doing by buying that product. He can be a consumer, he can be a user of your product, or he can be just coming to your website to look into that. You know, so we need to understand the journey. Then we need to create an omni-channel of the customer experience and digital experience, replacing the static content with an adaptive content by doing this analysis of your audience, so that we are way, you know, kind of forward rather than backward, right? We never anticipated, you know, that whole world will go digital, right? There are some businesses which really lost because they are not have a digital presence, and some really flourished because they were way ahead in their business. So say, for example, Target is one company which is way ahead. They already have this, you know, buy the product online and get on your roadside or a curbside. So that they have this policy, which they have launched the campaign long before pandemic happened. And that really helped them to kind of survive in this whole wave of 2020. But there are some business which really lost because they are late in game. So I think this is a market of consumer market we're talking about. And when we're talking about consumer market, it's very important for us as a content developer to become that translator and give them that experience, which probably help us to, you know, kind of understand the customer and understand the business and become that kind of, you know, translating the business for the experience, basically. So just want to wrap it here. I will, I'm also planning to kind of write a white paper on this, which I'll publish on my LinkedIn article, and probably you guys can look into that and provide your feedback. That will be helpful. Thank you.
Thank you, Ruchi. That was really enlightening. Only after your talk, I just realized that yesterday I was cribbing about all the apps stalking at me. And now I realize that I am the architect of my own misfortune. Only after your talk, I realized that. As content writer, I have been, should I say, architect of my own fortune or misfortune?